The Vijayanagara rulers were huge patrons of art and literature. They encouraged writers and poets in their empire. During the reign of the Vijayanagara rulers, many books and poems were composed in Sanskrit, Telugu, Kannada, and Tamil. Krishnadevaraya was also a poet. He wrote a Sanskrit drama, Jambavati Kalyanam, and a poem called Amuktamalyada. The poem told a story about daughter of Periazhwar and Goda Devi. She used to wear the garlands before offering it to the deity. The name Amuktamalyada means one who wears and gives away garlands. Even today, this poem is much appreciated by Telugu literary scholars and is considered to be an epic in Telugu literature. Another literary genius from Krishnadevaraya's court was Tenali Ramakrishna. He wrote Panduranga Mahatyam. Many scholars like Srinatha, Potanna, Jakamma, and Dugana translated works from Sanskrit and Prakrit to Telugu. The Vijayanagara rulers were also patrons of architecture. Many new temples and mandapas were built during their rule. Over time, the architectural style of these temples and mandapas came to be known as the Vijayanagara style. The great historian Percy Brown called this style the evolutionary form of Dravidian style. What was so special about the Vijayanagara style of architecture? The carvings, designs, and pillars were some of the most fascinating features of these structures. The horse was the most common animal that was depicted on the pillars and sculptures in Hampi. Another structure that was commonly built in Hampi was the mandapam. A mandapam is generally a raised platform. This platform is used to seat a deity on special occasions like festivals, etc. The Kalyana Mandapa of Virupaksha Temple in Hampi, Hazara Ramaswamy Temple, Vittala Swami Temple, Krishna Swami Temple, Kamala Mahal, and Sringeri's Vidya Shankara Temple are some of the finest examples of the temples of the Vijayanagara Empire. Temples of that period were built with strong granite rocks. They also had marriage halls adjacent to them. These halls were also elaborately decorated with carved pillars. Some other common features of temples were that they had spacious enclosures, high towers, meeting halls, and spring pavilions. Stone chariot, idols of Narasimha and of Ganapati are some of the other sculptures that illustrate the monolithic stone sculpture art form of the Vijayanagara reign. The places where the art and sculptures of Vijayanagara can be found are Kalahasti, Sri Shaila, Tirupati, Chidambaram, Srirangam, Kumbakonam, and Kanchi.
If you like this video and want to watch many, many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.